house. I'm gonna just use some alcohol and clean over the rollers here. And I've got some batteries for it, and I'm gonna put some film in it and see how it works. See if it takes any good pictures. Looks like it needs to be cleaned out pretty good, so I'm gonna be working on that some. And then we'll put some film in it and see how the pictures look. Alright, so I cleaned the rollers really good and everything. This here is the Polaroid Land Camera. It's Polaroid 360. I have another one that I bought at Goodwill. Well, my mom bought me at Goodwill that was like about $5. They currently have one of these at Goodwill on Parrish Avenue, but it's like $40, so I didn't really want to spend $40 on another one of these. If it was a lot cheaper, I'd probably buy it, because film is kind of expensive. It's about $20 for a pack of 10. And this here is a lot bigger, and it's really nice quality pictures too. I really like the way that they look and everything. Anyways, I'm gonna put the film in there. First thing we want to do is take off the front, which leads to this. Little button right here, you push that button in, and you take off this bottom. This here's the way it looks. You fold that up, and then there's some knobs here that you just kind of can pull or push, and it pops open and locks into place. I've never taken any pictures with this one. This is just one that I found at my grandparents' house, and I wanted to get some film and some batteries to try it out. I do have batteries for it. They're in here. I had to order them off of Amazon. They're like $5 a piece. Then the film is going to go into this back section here. It did have an old cartridge in it. Nothing was in it, but I thought that was kind of neat. Pretty neat for this camera. I like it. Alright. I believe it goes in like this. Maybe it goes in like this. I have no idea how this goes in. I'm assuming it goes in like this, because that's how this one came out. Yeah, so I'm assuming it goes in just like this. This here's the back of it. There's a little slot here, and I'm going to slide it down in there, and it clicks in. It says don't press here, so I'm trying not to do that. And I'm going to close it up. See, there's a little tab here. Now this is kind of the hard part, because you got to pull this black part out. It's coming out. Oops. Get it all out. cut that whole black piece out. Now all that's left here, this is my first picture, so there's a one on this piece of paper right here. So now all I have to do is get what I want in focus, which this is how you focus it. You're going to look through this viewfinder right here, and you're going to kind of move these back and forth until everything lines up in place. And then you are going to pull this down, and then you click the shutter button whenever you're ready to take a picture. I'm going to find a flower and take a picture of a flower. Alright, I don't know how well you can see me or not, but this here is the flower I'm going to take a picture of. I'm just going to kind of focus on it and then hit the red shutter button. Looks like I'm a little too close, so I'm gonna have to scoot back some. Alright, I'm ready to take the picture now. Shutter's supposed to open and close. So now what I'm gonna do, since I took the picture, again, I don't know how this is gonna turn out because this is my first time using this camera. I'm going to pull this white slip of paper out, and then it should pull out a picture. There's one piece. Here is the picture. And then this should be the picture. I'm going to give it just a little bit to develop. I don't really know if it's got to be in a dark spot or not with these. So I'm just going to kind of lay it over there and let it develop. I'm going to get another picture of maybe some more flowers, and then we'll see how they turn out. Something else you can do with these cameras, and I'm going to do it now, is it's called a double exposure. Like, basically, I can take a picture, and then before I pull out the picture, I can go take another picture and kind of mix them together, which is really cool. I've got some really pretty pictures from this camera. Well, not this one, but my other one, doing multiple exposures. So I'm just going to see maybe how many I can get from it. Maybe one of a yellow flower, one of a purple flower, and then maybe one of my rabbit. She is right behind me. I don't know if you can see her, but she's over there behind me. And I'm gonna get a picture of her, and then some of some flowers, and see if I can mesh it all together into one picture. How it turns out. Alright, so now that I've taken three pictures with this, I've taken a couple of flowers, and then I took a one of my bunny rabbit. I am going to pull this picture out, and it should be about three pictures in one, multiple exposures. So we'll see. And this is number three for me, so I still have 7 pictures left. And this here should be the one with 3 pictures in one. Now I have 7 pictures left, and I just gotta figure out what I wanna take pictures of next. But while we're waiting on that, there is a couple here that should already be fully developed. The thing with these, the peel-off kind, is you want to make sure you let it dry fully. So you don't want them touching each other after you peel it off, because around the edges it's still going to be a little sticky. So let's see how this turned out and if my camera worked right. Ooh, it looks like it worked right. Oh, perfect, beautiful. And you also have a negative. If you look at it right here, I don't know if you can see it, but that is my negative. You can kind of see a little bit of the colors there. And this is my picture of the sunflower that I took. I love this film because it is so glossy and pretty and just vintage looking. It's perfect. I'm so happy that this camera works, because it's something that I found at my grandparents' house. I don't know if it was something they purchased, you know, because they were hoarders and they like to purchase a lot of stuff, or if it was something that they had that could have been handed down, but it's still really, really neat to have. And this picture here just turned out great. This is like my garden area, and there's the sunflower. Now we'll take a look at, I'm gonna put this down over here because the other picture can't touch it because it is still sticky around the edges. And I'm gonna peel off this picture, which should be of some red flowers. Again, turned out wonderful. Here is my negative. I don't know if we can see that all that well, but there's the negative of it. And here is my picture. You can see the flowers and then my statue. And this is a stepping stone that belonged to my grandpa that he made. It is so pretty. I love these pictures. They're great. They're great to have. Now that the sun has went down just a little, I might be able to show you a little bit better than you can actually see it. It's very pretty. The greens and everything, it just comes out really good. It is so neat to have. I love this camera. And we'll wait a few minutes and then I will show you the multiple exposure and we'll see how that one turned out. Alright, I think it's been a long enough time for us to check this one out and see what the multiple exposure came out to be like. This one here, I tried to get it as focused in as I could on the different things that I wanted. Whether or not it focused in good, I have no idea, but we'll see now if it did. It looks like it did get just about everything in there that I wanted to get. It's gonna look like a messed up picture because there's like two or three different pictures in it, but it's still pretty cool. You can see my rabbit up here. This is where I